Welcome back to Growing Craft. Please do subscribe to our channel before we start this video and do not forget to hit the bell icon so that you do not miss out any of our updates. Also do check our website www.growingcraft.com and let's get started. So finally today we are giving a makeover to this box which we had shown you in an unboxing video. I hope you have seen that. Just in case if you have missed out that video, please do check. I'll share the link in the description box and I hope you are going to love that. Now I need to prep up my base, so here I'm using a white color gesso and with my fan brush I'm going to give a nice prepped up coat on my base. Now gesso is very important. Either you can use your sponge dauber or your paint brushes, anything you want. Now with the sponge dauber you will get a very smooth finish. With the paint brushes, like especially mine, the bristles have become really hard because I've been using the same brush for 2 years now. So of course even though I clean it on regular basis immediately after use, but they tend to get old, of course. So yeah, I am going to get some marks here and there, but I really wanted that. That's the reason I have picked up my paint brush. Now if you don't have the sponge dauber, you can even use your Anukul brushes. They work absolutely fine and I'm a big fan of Anukul brushes, so I highly recommend that. Now I'm just dabbing some of the gesso and then I'm spreading it on my complete box. Now honestly the base is so smooth that I really did not have to do 2-3 coats on this one, but many a times when I'm doing my gesso work I really need to work a lot with the prepping of the base because either there's a problem with the gesso or with the paste, or maybe I did not do it that great that I had to do 2-3 coats of gesso. But for this one my paint brush worked out really well. Just one coat of gesso worked really well. Now here I'm using my heat gun and I'm going to make this super dry so that I can move on to the next step. Now why do we use heat gun? Because it really saves a lot of time when you are doing your crafting work. It helps in speeding up your work process. Now if you don't have a heat gun, you can use hair dryer, but there is a huge difference in hair dryer and heat gun. So please do check a video I have done it on my YouTube channel. I'll share the link down in the description box that why heat gun is important when you are doing your mixed media and your decoupage art. I know it's a little investment when we say it, like it's in the range of 1000-1500, but it is totally worth it. Now here I'm dabbing my gesso on the top of my box. Also I'm not going to paint the box right now because right now what I have decided, I'm not going to do anything inside the box. Let's see how it goes at the end. Now using my heat gun I'm going to dry this up completely so that we can move on to the next step, and trust me friends, this is looking so smooth, so nice, and a very fine texture of my brushes and looks gorgeous. Now only on the lid I did my second coat of gesso. Why? Because I have to do decoupage on the top of it. So whenever I'm doing my decoupage I prefer to have a white color gesso a lot so that my napkin color pops out really well. So my base has dried out completely and it is super awesome to work on a very smooth and a finished surface. I really like it. Now with a thin brush I am using my water brush technique to make sure that I trim this paper really well. Now I'm just going to take out the portion which I'm going to use on my base. So this technique really helps in cutting down your paper. You don't have to use your scissors here. If you guys don't have decoupage napkin, you can choose any of your designs from your decoupage papers. Also, do let me know in the comment section whether you like your decoupage papers more or tissues more. I will be very happy to know that. Now just removing all the excessive papers from the sides, whichever I don't want it. Once I'm done with it, then I'm going to use my decoupage glue. Now here what I'm using is a Mod Podge, but if you want, you can use your decoupage glue and that works perfectly fine. There is no issue with the kind of adhesive you are using. It depends on what you have available with you. Now there is a big question, can we use Fevicol? No, you cannot use Fevicol because there is a huge difference in Fevicol and decoupage glue and Mod Podge. So please guys, use something good which is good for your project, which will make your project last for a longer time. Of course, when you are putting up so much of effort, it must last long, right? I hope I'm making sense. Okay, so here we are done with the sticking work. Now it's time to dry this up. And for drying this up, I am going to use my heat gun. Now I'm just pressing this with my fingers and trying to make sure that I remove all the wrinkles and bubbles from there. Honestly, there were very few, so I'm happy about it. Okay, so after my drying process, it took a little time, yes. Now it's time to move on to the next step. Now usually whenever I use my decoupage napkins, I use my varnish to seal this one. Why I do it? Because I just want to make sure that when I do my color blending technique, it should not smudge with my napkin. Now if you are using a decoupage paper, honestly you can chuck this part, because with the decoupage papers it is way more easier. It is way more smoother to work with the decoupage papers. Of course, napkin has its own charm, but decoupage paper makes it much more easier. If you are a beginner, you should go for decoupage papers. Try your hands with that and then you can switch on to the napkins. So finally, the color blending technique has started, and this is one of my favorite part whenever it comes to doing a decoupage in mixed media art, and especially with the iCraft chalk paints. I'm a big fan of them, so that's the reason I have picked up two shades from their chalk paint collection. Initially when I started this, I thought I'm going to use this lighter gray and I'm going to do this on my complete project, but then later on I felt that I should add a tinge of blue also, which is there on my Insta sheet, which you'll be seeing later on. Now it's not that whichever Insta sheet color you're using, you have to use the same color. Going with the contrast color also works really well. I will try to post a video with that really soon, so do check that too. Now if you scroll down to my video, you will see a lot of color blending videos where I have used a lot of water, or I have just done the color blending with just my chalk paints. And trust me friends, color blending technique is super easy and it is one of the fun techniques to work with. Now here I am not being very particular about which color I want where and how much I want it, so I am just going with the flow. I have just picked up the colors which I wanted and I am just playing around with it. Now on the lid, initially I did just the gray color, but later on you will see me doing a lot of blue also. And if you want, you can just mix up these two colors, create your own colors, and even working out with that also works pretty well. Now I have been asked that why do I add water to my color blending technique. I add water to it because I want to give it a nice watercolor look. That is the only reason. Otherwise, if you see this tutorial here, I'm not using any water at all. This is just my chalk paints and I'm doing the color blending technique. Ideally, this should be the way you should do it, because it adds a little more strength, because the moment you add water, you are diluting your color. You are just taking out the actual color from it. So yes, this is the true color and this is the true way of doing your color blending technique. Now like I said, I'm going to cover up some of the blue colors, a little darker color on my lid also, and once this is done, then I'm going to let it dry for a good amount of time. Otherwise I won't be able to start with my next step. And yes, letting your projects dry is a very important thing. Now you will see me using Insta transfer sheet here. These are amazing sheets. So honestly, on the top of the lid I'm going to work a lot, and on the bottom part I did not want to work more. So yeah, these are one of the best sheets to work with. If you're a beginner, try your hands on this and I'm sure you're going to love this. Now here I'm just going to cut my borders from this, and once I am done with that, then I'm going to cut it to the size of the box lid what I have. Now here you can see me struggling with from where I have to cut and what I have to cut. I just realized there is some extra sheet of paper, the plastic. I'm going to cut that, and then I'm going to use my trimmer to cut it to the size of my boxes. Now honestly, I wanted to do a lot of mixed media, like a different technique work. So here I'm going to cut these to the size of my box portions. So there are six sides. I'm going to do my Insta transfer on three sides, and three sides will have the other work, which you can see at the end of this video. So yes, a lot of gold gliding and a lot of stamping, and of course the color blending. I know you guys love color blending. because on each and every of my video I see a lot of requests for color blending technique. Trust me friends, that is one of the most easiest thing what you can do with your projects, and once you get a hold of that, you are going to love that. Now quickly I'm cutting all my stuff here just to make sure that I get the exact sizes, and once I'm happy with that, then we are going to use these. Now I have done a lot of video on image transfer. They are a big hit. People love image transfer, and yes, there are so many ways of doing these, and now these kind of sheets in the market, it becomes much more easier to work with. Now once you are done with your cutting work, or the fussy cutting work, or the straight cutting work, or if you are using the sheet as it is, you just need to remove the plastic film and stick it to your base. One very important thing that you need to make sure that your base is completely dry. Second very important thing, that your base should be clean, it should not have any dirt. If you have checked on these two points, you are so good to go. Now I am sticking these sheets on the alternate portions, and I will just make sure that I press them really well. They should stick to your base really well. Now the portion with the moment you remove the plastic film, you will see something sticky portion. Be a little careful when you are sticking that. Now it's time to do a little bit of fussy cutting work. Now I have already sticked my Insta transfer on my sides of the jar. Now I need to stick it on the lid. So now if I'm sticking it on the lid, of course I have already done a pretty little face on the top of it, so I just wanted to do a bit of fussy cutting work. Now this is just to make sure that my lid has a nice touch of the side work whatever we have done. So a very quick fussy cutting work. If you want, you can chuck the decoupage part, you can just do the directly Insta transfer work, even that also works really well. It depends on the kind of work and look and feel you want. Now for the fussy cutting work, I particularly use this teeny mini scissor, and I have been using this for past 6-8 months and I absolutely love it. Now sticking my Insta transfer sheet, and it is the same, you just need to peel off the plastic film, stick it really well. Now as my lid has some of the edges and lines and marks, so I will have to make sure that I stick it on each and every corners really well, otherwise while taking it out, it is just going to get rinsed off. Now I am going to stick this extremely randomly. If you want, you can create a beautiful pattern out of it. I am still left with some of the Insta transfer sheets with me, like some of the cutouts are still there. If I wanted, I could have used more, but I was pretty happy with these number of cuttings, and I really like these ones. Now the fun time begins, that how to remove your Insta transfer sheets. So just dab it with water. Here I'm using my Anukul brush. Just dab your brushes on water, quickly make your Insta sheets wet. And here is a very quick tip: the moment you realize that you can see the design of your lid, the Insta sheet, that means your sheets are ready to be removed, the backing sheet. So here I just goofed up because I added too much of water. Just be a little careful. Now this was super easy and this is looking gorgeous. I know the face of the lid is looking incomplete because I have to work on that, and that we will be doing very soon. Now it's time to dab it. Now for the bigger surface here, I'm using a sponge dauber. You can use any of your sponge pieces or even your bigger flat brushes. It's absolutely fine. Now once you make all the portions dry, and once you see the like almost 40-50% of your designs, that means you are almost done. Just slide it, or you can just peel it off, and it comes out really easy and smoothly, which you will be seeing now. So this is one of the super easy way of decorating your home decor or your artwork. Now I have done trays with these kind of sheets, I have done wall frames, I have done clock, what not, I have done like anything and everything, like on tin boxes to my plastic bases to my wood pieces, MDA, and yeah, almost on all the surfaces, even on the canvas and the cloth also, they work absolutely fine. You just need to be a little careful on how you are using these articles. So here I'm done with my Insta sheets, and now I'm just pressing this with my paint brushes so that it sticks well. So finally, my massive stamps are here. They are like such a big savior. So whenever I have to do anything in mixed media and decoupage, I cannot go without them. I would highly recommend you guys to check these stamps. These are one of the amazing stamps and one of the best used stamps. Now here I am using a permanent ink. Now if you don't have a permanent ink pad, I have a quick solution for you guys. I am sharing a video down below, the video link of ink pads where I have used one of the dye based ink pads as your permanent ink pad. That takes a little time, but then it will work out. Be a little patient and then definitely it will work out. Otherwise, I'm sharing the link of these ink pads in the description box. You can check that. Also, I'm sharing all the supplies link down in the description box. You can check that and I'm sure you are going to love that. Now here I'm using two patterns of stamps. One is my scrim, the other one is honeycomb. I just felt that doing a mix combo of these stamps is going to look really great, and it really turned out to be beautiful. So after the stamping work, it's time for gold gliding. Here I'm using my favorite sticky glue. This is one of the best glues which you can use for your ticker patch, for your mixed media, and even for your gold foiling. So I really don't have to buy a different glue for all the purposes. So this is one of the best thing which I would recommend you to buy. I'm sharing the link down in the description box. Do not worry about that at all. Now how I do it, I always use my Anukul brushes for this. I put up my glue, then immediately I use my gold sheets, the gliding sheets, and with the help of my Anukul brushes I just spread it. Either you can do it on the complete area, but as we have already done such a beautiful insta sheet work and the color blending work, I really did not want it to do cover it up completely. So here I'm using my gliding sheets on bits and pieces of my boxes, and of course a lot on the sides, because the sides are which is going to be much more visible when you keep it on a table as a decor piece. So yes, here we are almost done with the lid part, and then we are moving on the sides part. So this process is pretty easy. Apply your glue and then immediately you can use your gliding sheets. But this does not happen with some of the other glues which I have used or shown you guys in my previous videos. You need to wait for 10-15 minutes. I know it takes a lot of time, like just imagine waiting for 15 minutes to move on to the next process. I really do not have that much of patience, and honestly with such kind of adhesive, I think it is a much more savior than to have anything which takes a lot of time, because with just one glue I can stick my decoupage napkins, I can use it for my gold gliding and whatnot. So yeah, big thumbs up to this product. So here I'm repeating the same process. Now one of the very important thing, I always use my Anukul brushes for these process, like whatever the videos, tutorials, everything I do. And I do make sure that after immediately use of each brush, I soak them in water, I clean them in a very nice running water, tap water, and then I also clean them immediately with my hand wash. So what I do is I take a small container, I quickly dip my brushes in that, I quickly clean up everything. I try to make sure that after each use, I just take out all the colors and mediums from the brushes so that they last long. And trust me, the brushes what you are seeing me using now have been there with me for quite a good time. You cannot see any colors on it, you cannot see any other mediums. Even for the gold foiling, you can't see that. So yeah, gold gliding is something which takes a lot of leaves actually a lot of thing on your brushes. So yeah, please do make sure that you clean up your brushes immediately, especially after this step, and I'm sure you're going to love how your brushes are lasting so long. Now another very common question that I have been asked is, can we do gold gliding on complete surface? Yes, absolutely you can do it. Now can we use any other glue for gold gliding? No, you cannot use any other gold gliding. Some of the brands, they come up with a specific gold this gliding glues, but this is just because it's a one glue for all purpose. That's why I'm recommending that. If you have other glues which are made only for gliding ones, you can use that too. Now at the end, it's time to seal it up, and here I have my varnish and I'm going to use my varnish. If you don't have this particular varnish, you can use your decoupage varnish. It's absolutely fine. I'm sharing links of all the alternates, whatever I can, in the description box. And this is looking super gorgeous. This is like absolute gorgeous project which I have done recently, and that's the reason the moment I done this project, I wanted to share this with you guys, and I hope you all are going to like it. Now here I'm going to have good 2-3 coats of varnishes. I highly recommend that please use your varnishes, like good 2-3 coats of that, and that will make your project really last. So I really hope that you all enjoyed this video. Please do let me know in the comment section if you guys have any query, and also do let me know if you like this video. And thank you so much for watching, guys. Take care. Do subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye-bye. À deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. À deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. J'ai presque pu le goûter.
poids de nos lèvres, de doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, de doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer.
Le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer.